under 35 minuters spel. Och när jag säger det, då kommer mål nummer 4 i matchen. Det betyder 3-1. Är det galant igen?
Hi everyone, so I just want to do a quick analysis of this goal here, particularly because it is a great example of the failure of zone defense under certain circumstances. So it's a goal by Falun, the pink team, against Växjö, the white team. I'll just set the scene right now. The pink team has the ball here and they're heading this way. You probably already saw that in the clip of the goal. So I'll just move it forward a little bit. Just take note of where the pink players are. Here they are, and as the camera pans across, you'll be able to see the additional fifth pink player plus the rest of the white players. So I'll just move it forward a little bit so we can get a more full example of the shot here. If you've watched any of my videos before, you know I'll establish defensive pairs, and I'll do it for this one as well because I want to analyze the defense. So if we want to establish who's responsible for who defensively, if we had to make a choice, you would probably say that this guy is responsible for the ball carrier. This guy here is paired up with the pink player that was off camera. This guy here is paired up with this pink player on the opposite side of the court. This net front white defender is paired up with the player in the middle, Galante, who eventually scores the goal. And this white player here is paired up with the pink player who is in the corner there. So they're the defensive pairings. However, the white team is not really aware of who their defensive responsibility is on an individual level. They are only aware of whether they're in formation or not. And they also are not reading how their formation needs to be implemented based on the movement and the position of the opposition players, because you can see they're just standing in this nice sort of 2-2-1 or house structure. They're standing in that formation very well, but it doesn't stop them getting scored against. So a couple of things lead me to believe that they don't have awareness of what's going on here, and they're only standing in that formation. Number one is that the eventual goal scorer and the recipient of the pass that's about to occur, Galante, he has been in that position for a decent amount of time. He didn't just arrive there. He's been standing there asking for the ball for at least a couple of seconds now. I'll take it back a few steps to here. You can see he's still there now. And this guy carries the ball up. I have reason to believe that he's been there even longer than is shown in this clip. He's been there for a while and no one has taken him away. He's in a prime scoring area there. There's no denying that. And the fact that no one has taken him away means that there's probably a lack of communication, and there's definitely a lack of reading the play and taking initiative. So this guy here should really have stepped up and taken away the space or closed that gap so that if the ball does come through, he's got a chance to disrupt the reception of the ball. He can give the player a little bit of a bump, or he can get his stick around one side or the other to block the shot or dispossess the recipient of the ball. The other thing is that there's absolutely no disruption of the pass in here. We've already said that this player could disrupt the ball when it's received by the guy in the middle, but also you would think that this guy would potentially make a little bit more of an attempt to block the pass in. Maybe he would move himself a little bit more central so that this player has to play down this side or something like that. But he just seems to stand there and this ball just goes right through this gap here. Lastly, just on that, there doesn't seem to be any aim of this 2-2-1 structure. They don't seem to be trying to, you know, move the play to one side. Are they forcing it down this side? Are they forcing it down the other side? They don't seem to be trying to stop the play to the middle, because clearly the ball carrier just brings the ball up and passes it into the middle without really any impediment at all. So I just think that this is a prime example of a formation, but the players are not making reads, and thus they're standing in formation, but they're not actually taking away any threats. I think it's always important that defensive players, they need to make the read as to who they're responsible for, and then they either need to bend or break the system that they're in order to neutralize the threat, because the attacking team is going to keep moving around positionally. They're going to keep cycling the ball around and changing the point of attack. No single formation is going to be able to mitigate all of the threats if the attacking team is constantly changing their own formation. So that's really it for the defensive side of things. The last thing I'll say is just take note of the quick shot. Galante gets the ball in. He doesn't waste time. He pretty much turns and releases before this player here can even close the gap. And it just shows you the value of a quick shot. A quick shot, particularly from a dangerous location like this, will a lot of the time catch the goalie unawares or catch the goalie before they're able to set up. So that's all I really have to say on this one. Leave any comments below. What do you think about zone systems? Do you prefer zone or man on man? How should zone systems be implemented? Also, if you've got any ideas for video topics or goals that you'd like to see analyzed, please put a comment below and I'll do my best to reply to them and get those videos out. So thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one.
Under 35 minuter spel, och när jag säger det, då kommer mål nummer 4 i matchen. Det betyder 3-1. Är det Galante igen?